You, good evening. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful, all praise due to Allah, the cherisher and the sustainer of the universe. We bear witness there is no worthy of worship besides Allah. We bear witness that whom Allah Ta'ala guides through His infinite mercy and wisdom, one cannot be misguided. And whom Allah Ta'ala misguides, one cannot be guided to the right path. If I was to ask any of the youth today that what is success and who is successful, some might say, oh, the one with the well-paid job, the one with the most beautiful wife, the one with the glamorous car, the one with the huge and the most luxurious mansion. Some might even give the example of Bill Gates, for instance. He's a billionaire who's living his life with the dollar and the dime. And some might even give the example of Jeremy Clarkson. Why? Because he's famous and he's got the cars, he's definitely got the cars and he's rich. Some might even give the example of Cristiano Ronaldo. Because why? Because he's got the looks, he's got the physique, he's got he's got the looks, he's got the physique, he's got the money. And he's definitely got the fame, and most of all, he's definitely got the honeys and the bunnies. So my brothers, you should realize that the reality is, you are not successful. You are not successful due to the car that you own. You are not successful due to the mansion that you live in. You are not successful due to the wife that you are married to. You are not successful because of the well-paid job you get. But brothers, the reality is we are in this dunya. We are living in this dunya. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا حَيَاتُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاءُ الْغُرُورِ. That life in this dunya is nothing but an illusionary deception. Life in this dunya is nothing but an illusionary deception. So you see, my brothers, this world we live in is a trap. Do not fall for the money, do not fall for the honey and the bunnies, do not fall for the cars, do not fall for the mansion. Like a shaykh says, هي الدنيا تقول بملء فيها هي الدنيا تقول بملء فيها هذاري هذاري من بطشي والفكي فلا يغرركم مني ابتش فلا يغرركم مني ابتسام فلا يغرركم مني ابتسام فقولي مضحك وفعلي مبكي وفعلي مبكي. So the shaykh says, the dunya, it declares openly that fear for my grip and my assault. And he says, and do not become dazzled, do not become seduced by the smile that I display. Do not become seduced or become dazzled by the smile I display. Because why? Because my action, my utterance may seem sweet. My utterance may seem sweet, but my actions are bitter. You see, my brothers, we live in this dunya not for fun. We live in this dunya not for money. We live in this dunya according to Allah and His Rasul. We live in this dunya according to the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, الدُّنْيَا سِجْنُ الْمُؤْمِنِ وَجَنَّةُ الْكَافِرِ. That dunya is a prison for the believers. Dunya is a prison for the believers. But it is a paradise for the non-believers. But the question is, my brothers, who is successful and what is success? See, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ زُحْزِهَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ. Whoever is saved from Jahannam and is entered into paradise, then he is successful. Then he is successful. You see, my brothers, A true mu'min will have great iman and conviction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will have, not only that, he will also have love for Allah and love for his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is why he will also remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every aspect of his life, in every moment of his life. That is why a shahid, he says, هردم هردم الله الله كر ہر دم اللہ اللہ کر نور سے اپنا سینہ بھر جیت اس کا ہو کر جیت مر تو اس کا ہو کر مر
سبحان اللہ سبحان اللہ.
See my brothers, we live in this dunya not for fun. We live according to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is why Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that value five things before these five things occur. اغتنم خمسا قبل خمس. Value five things before these five will occur. شباب قبل حرمك. That your youth before senilities shall overcome you. Your youth, that your old age shall overcome you. وصحتك قبل سقمك. And your health before illness strikes you. وغناك قبل فقرك. And your prosperity before your poverty. Your prosperity before your poverty. وفراغ قبل الشغل. And your free time before you are occupied. And not only that, he mentioned وحياتك قبل موتك. And your life before death comes to you. You see, my brothers, to love Allah, if you have love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and love for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one is successful. And there is no one who loves Allah and his Rasul more than Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. No one loves Allah and his Rasul besides Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. He said that no mother will love her child more than Abu Bakr loved the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is not an exaggeration, my brother. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, لَوْزِنَ بِإِمَانِ أَبُو بَكْرِ بِإِمَانِ أَحْلِ أَرْضِ لَا رَجَأَ بِهِمْ. That if you were to scale the iman of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu with the iman of the entirety of humanity, then the one iman of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu will outweigh the entirety of humanity. Say subhanallah, my brother.
Subhanallah.
When Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, when he was with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the cave, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, being a true gentleman, he said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, oh my beloved, allow me to enter the cave before you. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he granted him permission. When Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he entered the cave, he got rid of all the harmful creatures and all the harmful obstacles that were in the cave. And once he was in the cave, he saw numerous holes in the cave. And what Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu did, he tore off his garment and made many pieces. And what he did with his garment, he blocked all these holes with his garment. And he called the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam put his Mubarak head on the thigh of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And whilst the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sleeping, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he was looking around and he saw one hole that was unblocked. What Abu Bakr did, he thrust his foot into that hole. And without even knowing, there was a serpent in this hole. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he thrust his foot into this hole. And as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sleeping, this snake began to bite the foot of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. It began to bite. Whilst the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sleeping on his thigh, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu didn't even move a muscle. Because his beloved was sleeping on his thigh. So what happened? He didn't even move his muscle. Imagine, my brothers, imagine the excruciating pain that Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu he went through. Imagine the agony that Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu went through. And then finally, a tear fell from his eyes on the Mubarak face of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which caused the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to wake up. And when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam woke up, he saw the agony on the face of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he says, oh my beloved, forgive me, I did not mean to wake you up, I did not mean to disturb you. So What Allah, what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did, he got his mubarak saliva, his mubarak lu'ab, his blessed saliva, and he placed it on the foot of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And what happened? This was one of the miracles of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that this foot, he was healed. This bite by this snake was not there. It was vanished. So what, you see, my brothers. No mother will love her child more than Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu will love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And why not during the expedition of Tabuk, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he told the Sahabas to give in charity. Why? Because this will aid the army in artillery, in water, in food, and as well as the armor that the soldiers use. So what happened? Umar radiallahu anhu, he was there, he heard the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So what, he began to think that if I'm gonna beat Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu in a good deed, then it will surely be today. Because why? Because Umar radiallahu anhu, he was more financially stable than Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. So what Umar radiallahu anhu did, he went home and he grabbed as many things as he could, and he came back to the majlis of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he placed his load in front of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He placed his load in front of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, seeing this, he said, "MashaAllah, Umar. MashaAllah, so tell me, what have you brought for Allah and His Rasul?" He said, "Ya Rasulullah, I have brought half of my wealth in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, "MashaAllah, so what have you left for your family?" So the Umar radiallahu anhu replied that I left the other half with my family. Said the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, "MashaAllah, you have done good, Ya Umar." And then while he went back and he sat down here and he's waiting for Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu to arrive, because he knew that today I will beat Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu in a good deed. And eventually when Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu came with his load, he placed it in front of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Oh Abu Bakr, what have you bought for Allah and His Rasul?" Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he says, and listen to this, my brothers. He said, "Ya Rasulullah, I have bought my whole wealth in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he looked at Abu Bakr, he said, "MashaAllah, Abu Bakr, MashaAllah, so what have you left for your family then?" Then listen to this, my brothers. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he said, that I have left Allah and His Rasul. I've left Allah and His Rasul. And this is more sufficient than anything else. This is more than sufficient, my brothers. That is why Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he had immense love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He had immense love for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I'm going to cut this short. Before the death of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he goes to his daughter Aisha radiallahu, "Oh my beloved daughter Aisha, oh my beloved Aisha, you are the beloved wife of my beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Aisha, tell me, what day is it today?" And Aisha replied, she says, "It is Sunday, my father, it is Sunday." And then Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he says, that "What day did my beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam pass away?" And she says, "Oh my father, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he passed on a Monday." Then Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he says, "I am optimistic, my daughter, oh my daughter, oh my beloved daughter, I am optimistic and I am certain that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take my life on a Monday. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take my life on a Monday." And when Monday came, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he went back to his daughter and he said, "Oh my beloved daughter, so tell me, what time did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away?" She says, Oh, my beloved father, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he passed away just before noon. He passed away just before noon. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he replies, my beloved daughter, I am optimistic and I am certain that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take my life away just before noon. And the narration mentions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took the life of Abu Bakr just before noon, just before his beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Aisha radiallahu anha mentions that my father died just like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That my beloved Prophet, he died on my lap, and my father in the same way died on my lap. You see, this is the tawfiq that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he gave to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This was a tawfiq. You see, my brothers, where did the Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, where was he buried? He was buried next to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was right man in this dunya and right man in the qabr. Companion in this dunya and companion in the qabr. That's why he was labeled as the Sati and the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And you see, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that Abu Bakr was my companion in this dunya, and he shall be my companion in the akhirah, and he shall be my companion in this in the akhirah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that Abu Bakr was my companion in this dunya, and he shall be my companion on the Hawza Kawthar. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that there will be 8 doors that will call out for certain people for this dunya. 8 doors. For example, one door, the one in Jannah. This is in Jannah, by the way. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, one door, there'll be one door that will call out for those people who prayed the namaz in this dunya. And he will say, oh, those who prayed namaz in this dunya, enter me. And there will be another door in Jannah. There'll be another door in Jannah for those who fasted in this dunya. And he will say, oh, those who fasted, enter me. And there'll be another for those who fasted, who wrote masjid in the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he will say, enter me. And so on. And there will be 8 doors. And one of the Sahaba, he asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, will there be any door for anyone, for any person, that all 8 doors will call? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, yes, it will be only for Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. Say subhanAllah. And the ultimate reward, listen to this, my brothers, the ultimate reward that Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu will receive. And listen carefully, my brothers. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to Abu Bakr, Ya Abu Bakr, you have received Ridwan al-Akbar. You have received Ridwan al-Akbar. And there's some Sahabas around, and they are scratching their head, and they are saying, Ya Rasulullah, what is Ridwan al-Akbar? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, يَتَجَلَّ اللَّهُ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ عَامَّ يَتَجَلَّ اللَّهُ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ عَامَّ in Jannah. When the mu'mineen, when they enter Jannah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the people, to all the mu'mineen in Jannah, that is there anything else that you desire? Is there anything else that you desire? Then the mu'mineen, they will say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, you have saved us from Jahannam and you have entered into Jannah. What more can we ask for? And then that is when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will say, He will unveil himself for only for the mu'mineen, front of all the mu'mineen, he will unveil himself. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned that this sight will be better than all of Jannah put together. This sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be better than all of Jannah put together. You see, my brother, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, يَتَجَلَّ اللَّهُ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ عَامَّ, that Allah will unveil himself in front of all the mu'mineen. And listen to this, وَيَتَجَلَّ اللَّهُ لِلْأَبِي بَكْرِ خَاسَّةً, and for Abu Bakr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will solely and only will he come only for Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. only for Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. Say subhanallah, my brothers. You see, my brothers, we live in this dunya is a trap, you see. Loving this dunya will get you nowhere. Loving this dunya will get you nowhere. Loving the Hollywood, loving the Bollywood, loving the Lollywood, loving the Gollywood, and so on, the list will go on. Loving the Lady Gaga, loving Shah Rukh Khan, loving Cristiano Ronaldo, loving Tupac, loving Biggie, loving Jay-Z, and loving Abdul Hai will not get you nowhere. Will not get you nowhere, my brothers. Will get you nowhere. Loving Allah and His Rasul, loving Allah and His Rasul will enter you to paradise. Having firm belief and conviction in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also loving the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will receive Jannah. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He give us the same taqwa as He gave Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gave us the same love that He gave to Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu for the Allah and His Prophet. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He makes a means of rahmah for me on the Day of Judgment and not against me. Wa akhiri da'wa anna alhamdulillah.